okay? They are troubling me, no? The Shisha said. They are not troubling you. They are reminding you that you have to understand you are not the body, mind and intellect. So they have performed them, then they are also coming for teaching you.
There is also a guru.
They are also a guru. Understand? So, kicks in life are great teachings. You think God comes in only one form? He comes in the form of mosquitoes also. So mosquitoes have come and teach you to understand that I am not the body. So Ramana Maharshi has sitting, I am not the body. The mosquitoes are coming with you. So my Guru Ajja told me, I told you only to do. Who are you? Find out. Then sit silently. Then he said, sitting silently means what he meaning is. If the mosquito comes and sits in space, don't do like this. That's his definition. Don't move because you are not the body. So gradually what will happen with the clarity as jnana goes deeper and nididhyasa becomes deeper, your impressions of I am the body and the mind and the intellect will disappear. And the world will disappear. That is called mukti. So, then there is a question. Vedanti teaches Shravana Matrena Jnana. Just listening is liberating. Why Manana Nidhyasa is required? So, Shravana gives a clarity. Now, whatever I give is clarity. This is absolute crystal clarity. No more, you won't get any more clarity than this. This all is clarity. You go and read any scriptures, you can't get more clarity. So, the clarity brings you conviction. You can live your life conviction. That's a good thing. Okay? But you may have some accumulated impressions, vasanas, they will come once in a while. So that manana nididhyas, you have to clear. Right? Already stored one is there now. So you don't have to empty stored ones. Every day do a little bit of maintenance, it will get empty. Are you clear? Any questions? Clear? Madam? Clear? Artha idha? Doubt idha? Okay. Now you had some question or experience now. What is the question?
That actually, this is our normal experience that the feeling of I, or whatever, that yeah, I am here and I am experiencing.
Right.
But the same when we think about the others, they are also seeing, they are also experiencing, they are also thinking.
Yeah.
That is not so obvious for us. So, but is it fact that there are multiple peoples and all are, that is, multiple people means multiple false eyes and who are having
your problem. Your problem is they or you. Who is your problem?
Problem is nothing, but actually when you say that self only is there, so how can there be multiple?
We'll come to that, right? First, who is your problem?
The mind is
solve it. Why are you bothered about others?
No, there are others, that is also part of the mind only. No?
Yeah. So your mind problem you solve.
No, how to solve that?
This one, no, Shravana.
That is why I am asking that if there are multiple objects, are there?
There are no multiple objects. That's your attention is on the world, then multiple objects will appear.
Now the others are thinking that thought I am not able to recognize. My thought I am able to recognize. So that means there is only my thought or there are others' thoughts also.
See this whole point, no? Your problem, are the other people's thoughts giving problem or your thoughts are giving problem? They are not giving. So ultimately it's yours. You resolve your thought problem and other people thought don't worry. So I'll ask the question, in your dream or deep sleep.
No, but in normal parlance we see, you are teaching us actually. So is it like that in my mind something is there that is teaching me the other image, one image, another image, or is it like the consciousness itself is having like that?
Then is there something other than consciousness?
No, nothing. And they are all consciousness.
So what is the question?
There are multiple images or not that, sir?
The multiple images are appearing, no?
Appearing.
So he is saying you are in his mind, so is he teaching himself?
There is only not he or not me. There is only consciousness. There is no he, no me. As long as you have he and me, there is a problem. There is only consciousness.
Teaching is happening in his mind.
Okay. His mind means his special mind, is it?
Individual mind.
He has an individual special mind?
No.
So where is the individual mind starts and where it ends?
That's what I am asking, sir. This is my mind.
Which is my mind?
This consciousness, actually.
Your finger is not your fingers. How can your mind be your mind?
You should have checked out your
thought. Huh? I just forget of mind. Mind is more subtle. Your finger is your finger?
No, but you said your perceptions are your individual mind.
What I'm saying, see, when I tell something, this only for understanding and getting over some problem. So you tell me, where is the boundary between your finger and the world?
There is no boundary.
So how can there be a boundary between your mind and somebody else's mind?
But I can't access somebody else's mind.
Oh, she has hunger. You don't have hunger?
That's not mind, right? That's
hunger is not a mind, of the part of the mind?
Body.
Hunger is mind. Everything is mind. Body is in mind.
Okay. Body is mind, then hunger is also in mind. Others feeling or others thought and all that doesn't come. So that means it is not there.
That doesn't come just
it
because...
It is not there. Okay.
No. That doesn't came. It doesn't matter to you, I'm saying. Does it matter to you?
Or understand that because...
Your problem is you solve your mind's problem. Whether other people's mind problem, don't worry about that.
Not a mind's problem. I'm telling about the other. They are also part of this mind, or is it?
There's no this mind or that mind. There's only one mind.
Only one mind. Okay. There are not multiple minds.
There's no multiple mind. Finger. The finger itself belongs to the universe. I'm saying where is the multiple mind? So this is actually I will tell you through Omkara. Okay. So your question I'll answer you. There's no. There's all one. Okay, so you are concerned, oh, I am something, something is in my head and all. Your hunger is her hunger. Her hunger is animal's hunger. Animal's hunger is tiger's hunger. Hunger is universal, not individual. Hunger and all are part of the basic mind. Now, what you are speaking of thoughts and all is just some learning from the society. So, what is universal? Basic hunger, thirst, sex, fear, they are all universal. It's not you, it's the universal mind. Yadevi
Sarva
Bhuteshu
Trishna
Rupena Samstita
Namastase
Namastase
Namo Namaha
Yadevi Sarva Bhuteshu
Lajja
Rupena Samstita
Namastase
Namastase
Namo
Namaha
Yadevi
Sarva Bhuteshu
Smriti
Rupena Samstita
Namastase
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 Namo
Namaha.
See, everything is universal. The Devi, hunger, thirst, fear, desire, anger, it is nothing specific to you. It's a part of universal mind.
So if there is a realization self, then so all of them are realized.
Huh? That's what happens. When a person is realized, he understands that all are realized. That's the first thing happens. And his Buddha said when he awakened, he realized the whole world is awakened.
Then there is no all also. Only
these are all the what I call as the confusion created by the words and mind.
Last time you said, Vidya Vinaya Sampanne Brahmani
Gavyasthine.
Vidya Vinaya Sampanne Brahmani
Gavyasthine. Gavyasthine. Enlightened one sees everything as the self. One who sees the self in everything and everything as self is only enlightened.
Reclaim? See, there is this actually concept of the multiple minds and all is actually again a mental concept. In your dream, you saw many people in the train. You start thinking that each people has one person and come Hyderabad and from Chennai. My dear, this one big dream is called collective dream of collective consciousness. You are leaving the dream of your grandfathers and grandparents. That dream is coming through you. You are leaving the dream of the society.
Your collective dream, you are telling me, all the dreams collected together.
It's one dream. It's one flow. So right now, the way you are wearing the dress, the way you are talking is not yours. It's a package from the society. So everything is one collective mind is working. If at all you are doing something, you are part of the collective mind, you are picking up something and doing it.
So, but I think this mind is mind and others having their
separate. That this mind. And other is also again a concept, no? I just showed you the finger, no? What is called, what you call this and other is a mental concept, no? Isn't it? ಬೆರಳು ಸಾಕು ಕಾಫಿ ಯಾರು ಕುಡಿದ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರು ಆತ್ಮದಾನ ನೀಡುತ್ತೆ ಕಾಫಿ ಯಾರು ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರು ಆತ್ಮದಾನ ನೀಡುತ್ತೆ conceptually real. When I say real, not real, it's transactionally real. Conceptually, not real. Absolutely not real.
When we practice in sadhana, that we practice ourselves as consciousness, then...
You don't practice yourself as well, you are consciousness.
But in that sadhana actually, what is our relationship with our the outside world?
There's no relationship. We are going back to somewhere is outside world. When you go back to deep sleep, there is no outer world at all.
Deep sleep is not there, but in daytime.
So what I'm saying is, when you do sadhana, the mind becomes distracted from I amness. Then you start feeling that everything is a part of I amness. Everybody is appearing in my consciousness.
Appearing in my consciousness. Okay.
Appearing.
Appearing in consciousness, including this image, self image.
Appearing as, not really.
This room, outside room is also concept appearing in that.
The outside room, inside room, the body, everything is appearing in mind. Mind is appearing in consciousness. All concepts in consciousness.
Now when there people say, no, having a siddhi of seeing far away and others thoughts.
So one, put means, one peg, you see beyond the walls also. That's a big siddhi.
But that means it is all false.
I'm not saying false, I'm saying real. Take one peck of whiskey and you'll see beyond the walls also what is happening. And you see what is not happening also, you'll see.
But that is only for the truth for himself. Others will not agree with him. There are people who are having siddhis who
ask for each person,
other people also
agree. After you put a peck of this thing, you realize that others also will agree with you. If you go and say the world is going round, they'll say, world is going round.
They will not dispute. It is dangerous to dispute.
The whole world will agree with you. See, these are all mental mind games. Why stuck about that? Go Atmadnara, Mukti, freedom.
Wake from the waking dream.
There are so many people do so many things. Somebody will read it. The third eye, fourth eye, and what is fourth dimension, fifth dimension, what's happening, all those things.
But our history actually, our Shastras and Vedas and all that, they point that, all that.
Okay, now that brings us another question. Okay? I forgot to tell you, experience. There are two types of experience. So, again, I should have told this earlier, but okay, good that you reminded.
of them say that for civilization siddhis are not required, but the book said all that, they say that in the process that people give this.
I don't know, because I never had any siddhis. What? So there are two types of experiences in life. One is called direct experience and other is called indirect experience. Okay? So let us understand this difference, because this is very important for us to understand Atmadhyana. Maitri. So there are two types of experience in life. There are two types of experience, okay? One is called direct experience and the other is called indirect experience. Okay. Out of this, which is more reliable? Okay? So, you say the Shastras are telling like this. Is it direct or indirect?
Indirect.
Okay? The entire spiritual journey is for direct experience. Direct experiences of two types. Pratyaksha Jnana, then Aparoksha Jnana. Okay? There are two types of experience, direct experiences.
It's not coming.
Oh, okay, sorry. There are two types of direct experience. Okay? One is called Pratyaksha and Aparoksha. Pratyaksha and Aparoksha. Okay, there are two types. So spirituality, the focus is only this, not the indirect experience. Indirect experience is helpful but not useful. Useful for journey, but the purpose is this. Okay? So through direct experience and Pratyaksha Jnana and Aparoksha Jnana, you have to find out who you are. So from direct experience, from Pratyaksha Jnana, Jnana to be used for realizing the truth of Anatma. Okay, I am not the body. The body is not real. This can be only through direct experience. Aparoksha Jnana. This is through. I am just telling. This is Vipassana. Aparoksha Jnana. I am Brahman. Or Atma Jnana. That is Anatma. Through Atmavichara, Nididhyasa. Sahaja Samadhi.
Aparoksha Jnana and indirect experience are different?
No. Indirect experience is what you have listened, heard.
And Aparoksha Jnana?
Aparoksha Jnana is, it is neither direct nor indirect. It is what you are.
What
you are. So, I'll give you an example, right? You go into a room, dark room. Is there a chair there, sir? I don't know. I need light. No. Somebody has told that there is a chair there. Yeah. Somebody has told me the chair there, but I can't see. Somebody has told me the chair is there. It's called indirect knowledge. I can't see it is called Pratyaksha, direct experience. So are you there, sir? yes, I am there. I am there, I exist, is aparoksha. For that, there is no light required. There is no external instrument required. I am there. Okay? So, the entire spirituality is to remove the confusion between I exist, I am there with the body mind. The overlapping. Are you clear? So, using vipassana, you remove the anatma. Using sahaja samadhi, you go back to atma. So now vipassana and sahaja samadhi both are required? I would say yes and no, depending on what you want. Alright? Any questions? In vipassana, you continuously observe your body. Observation is pratyaksha.
Sensations.
Now the mind will come and say, no, I am Brahman. Right? So is it direct or indirect? Indirect, because it's a memory. Memory is given, that memory somebody has told you. It's not real. Is it useful? But it's not direct experience. But your body and senses, sensations are direct experience. Got it? So continuously observe your body and sensation, then what will the sensation will dissolve? Then the feeling of no body is there. That's anatma. But I am Brahman, you just go straight to who am I? The counterpart, Atma, Anatma. So Buddha spoke of only Anatma, Ramana Maharshi spoke of only Atma. Are they speaking of opposite things? No. So you take both or one of them, get be free. Right? I would say just, yes?
Anatma. What is it? It's used for realizing the truth of Anatma. That has to be the first step.
No. It's not required that it is not required to be first step. It's not first step and second step. See what happens, many people, this itself is sufficient. Second one. Some people. Ramana Maharshi just went into this. Okay, some people this will help, but this unless we have clear aparoksha jnana, it will not solve the problem. That's what happens in many Buddhist teachings. So for some people, the combination of this will help. These are not steps. Right? Either this or both. Either or.
I would suggest Tanta, you had started saying.
Wait,
usually they go hand in hand.
They can go hand in hand.
Because knowing that you are not the body, mind or intellect, automatically means that you have to be the
Not necessarily. So, I am not the body, mind, intellect, but I remains. When you are the Atma, that I disappears. I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not the intellect. Somebody is denying it, right? Who is the denier?
The I.
In Atmadhyana, that I disappears. Negation will go to a stage until you negate the negator also. If you negate the negator, then you are there Atma. So the negating the negator is called Atma Vichara. Anyway, we'll do it now.
Okay.
Alright? So are you understanding what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Is this clear? To all? Everybody? Okay, let us go to step number 2, right? Which is Atma Vichara. I have told you Sahaja Samadhi, I have told you earlier. Okay, what I have not told you is Ramana Maharshi's simple teaching. Okay, I will tell all the three so that you are clear. Simple teaching Ramana Maharshi said, ask the question, who am I? That's all. Who am I? Finished. Okay? Nothing more. So now I want to change the question of who am I to something else so that the answer will be much more clear. Okay? So now I'll ask you the question, who am I? Who are you? What will you say? Who are you?
Unconsciousness.
So this is a mental answer. Sudha is a name given to you. Right? Is it Sudha is your direct experience? Out of this direct indirect is there, no? Sudha has come to you from the society. It's not your direct experience. Right? So who are you direct experience?
Consciousness. I don't have experience with that consciousness.
So do you exist? I mean, is it direct experience? I mean, you depend on existence proof for other certificate for a... Is it direct or indirect? Then I say I don't. You say I don't experience directly. Just now you said I don't experience directly. Is that direct experience? You exist is a direct experience.
Yes.
Are you conscious is a direct experience?
Yes.
That's direct experience. But your Sudha is indirect experience. See our illusion. What is our indirect experience? Because so prominent for us. Who told you our Sudha?
Society.
It's not direct experience for you. Right? You see how direct indirect experience is overriding the direct experience.
It's got mixed up.
Huh? It's getting mixed up. Right? So here we have to separate out what is direct experience, what is indirect experience. The whole spirituality is separate out indirect experience from the direct experience. Indirect experience is okay, useful. I'm not saying it's not useful. You being Sudha is very useful. Right? To somebody. Okay? So, we are not speaking of usefulness. What am I? Right? So, when you say come to what am I, you have to remove what you are not. What you are not is told to you. Okay? So, who are you, sir?
Not the body, mind.
That's also indirect experience. Because it's told by me.
Yeah.
You understand? Ardhada?
But it's... Shaivai, we have to realize
that
they are not just the body, mind, in fact,
we are
consciousness is realization, right? It's not...
Correct. So, what I am saying is, but are you getting carried away by the direct experience or indirect experience?
Indirect.
That's the whole point, no? You have to come back to...
Yes.
This is applicable for everything, like not only for Atma, like when we say that yesterday, tomorrow, it's also not about direct experience. Direct experience is now I am present.
Yesterday, what you are taking is a thought only, it's not real.
No, that's why it's not a direct experience. No. I can't be able to go to my past and see what...
Your past is not your direct experience. It's a thought now. Thought is not real.
Thought is real in this moment, no, present moment.
There's no thought in the present moment.
Then who is telling me that I went to home and I have a job to do and all...
They're all useful information, not real. There's a difference between useful information and not real. So, please understand, a map is there. Map is very useful. Okay? But it's not real. Map is useful. So, when I say thought is not real, thought is useful. But real moment, this moment is real. So, you had any time you had a cup of coffee? You drink coffee?
Yes.
So the coffee you drink, I drank coffee is a thought. But is it useful in this moment? You have to drink coffee, a cup of coffee. This moment it is to be experienced, physical experience. The past experience is just a unreal.
It is a thought.
Thought.
And thought is in the present moment, right?
Thought appears in the present moment,
yes.
But it is no reality.
No reality.
But usefulness. It's useful.
Useful, but it is appearing in the present moment.
It can appear only in the present moment.
Even past is not, useful, but it is, was not there also.
No. Past,
God is telling
past when you experienced it, it was present only.
Present only.
When you recall the past, you are recalling a past event now. It is a thought. It's not a current experience. It's a, distorted reality of a stored here. Something stored here.
Past was not there. Not only I'm saying, telling, it was not also there.
No, if you talk there, from the absolute point of view, there is no past, there is no present, there is no future.
Present is there. The present only, the past and future are there.
In your eye, is there a present also?
Yeah, present is eye. The presence is eye.
The eye appears as presence. The appearance of presence disappears also. This Chidabhasa. Presence is Chidabhasa.
consciousness.
Presence is consciousness, which is chidabhasa. But chidabhasa is pointing to real life, which is beyond time. There's no time there. No past, present, no present, no future.
That is what we use the word now. When we say now.
Now is for chidabhasa.
Chidabhasa. So now is there or not there also. It can be there, it can not be.
Absolute, where is the concept? Where is the concept of now also? No.
In all pervading, no time scale.
No time at all.
No, no time is there. That's where all collapsed to now.
That actually now is for chidabhasa. Because now is the current, referring to current moment. Chidabhasa.
Current moment you are
saying.
Yeah, current moment means okay.
No, no, when I say now, you are referring to chidabhasa.
Why we say that as chidabhasa?
No, I think the model is now he is referring to as now as a point in time.
No, no, not in point in time.
So that now is actually the presence, what you call as now.
Yes.
The presence is chidabhasa.
Correct.
In absolute eye, there is no presence and absence.
Permanent.
Right? No concept of presence and absence.
Yes.
There is no concept of no also. But this presence is pointing to absolute. This now is present, pointing to that. But in that, there is no time, there is no space, nothing.
Sir, you are teaching now, you are teaching to us, is an indirect experience to...
Indirect. It's called Paroksha Dhana, but Paroksha Dhana is very helpful, useful, but what can save you is your direct experience. Yes.
Nidhinyasa.
Okay. Shravana, Varana, Nidhinyasa. Shall we go?
Actually, sir, Vedas also, they say that the books are, this is indirect knowledge, but that is more important than the direct.
No,
with that only we experience the direct knowledge.
With that only you recognize the direct knowledge, don't experience it, because direct knowledge is always there.
So Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, what he does is, he asks his disciple to get the book on reverse and squeeze it and get water.
Water, you can't.
Yeah.
There's no water. Knowledge is there. Knowledge then it will tell you where to find the river also. Okay? So let us go back now. Is this understood clear, very experienced, direct knowledge, indirect knowledge? Teaching of Atmadarshana by Guru is called Parokshadhana, indirect knowledge. Was it useful? Very useful. But is that sufficient? You have to recognize yourself. For some people, it may happen like this. For some people, it may happen like this. For some people, it may happen like this. There are people who, through Parokshadhana, immediately they'll say, like this, got it. They are mature. For some people, yes, it will take some time. For same people, it will take time. But finally, pratyaksha jnana and aparoksha jnana can save you. Right? So pratyaksha jnana is, I am not the body you have to recognize by yourself. It may be logically also. I give you what you call as jagata, sopna, sushupti, jnana. What a miss jagati, miss sopna, miss sushupti. Or it can be through vipassana by observing the body. You can do that. It can be one of these or both of these. Right? Okay. So one who has pratyaksha jnana and aparoksha jnana, pratyaksha jnana, he is called sthita pradna. Pratyaksha jnana, pradna. Here it's called, this is called sthita pradna. So pratyaksha jnana, these two words together form sthita pradna. Sthita stands for aparoksha jnana. So he has aparoksha jnana and pratyaksha jnana. He has verified everything in the body and understood it's not, I am not. He has come to a conclusion, I am Brahman, I am unchanging Brahman. Both. He has solved the problem completely. Are you clear? Understood? Let us start. Okay. So let us go to teaching of Ramana Maharshi. First we'll do Sahaja Samadhi and then teaching of Ramana Maharshi. So now let me ask you a question. Okay, we're getting late.
No,
3 o'clock is the train.
No, 5 o'clock.
Okay. So, show me your left hand. Show me your right hand. Show me where are your thoughts. Mind or brain, right? Show me where is your awareness. Awareness?
Yeah.
All over. Right? So, you have to ask the question, am I aware? If I ask the question, who am I? Then answer will come, I am Sudha. You know, I am Sudha. You know, I am body, no, I am Atma, I am Brahman. Because mind will give answer. If you ask the question, am I aware, that what mind will give answer? Because awareness is not a part of the mind. Then straight away go to awareness. Right? Now let us ask this question and see what happens to you. Sit silently and ask the question, am I aware? If any thought comes, again ask, am I aware? Slowly open your eyes. So what happens when you ask this question, am I aware?
There isn't
awareness. Huh?
There isn't awareness.
I was, kind of zombie
types. Who
was
zombie types?
There's no answer.
So they say awareness.
It's right? Deep sleep state.
No thoughts come.
What happens to that?
No thoughts.
This is Ramana Maharshi's simple and direct path to Atmadnana. So this who am I question is misleading. Okay? Because the moment you say who am I start searching. I am Brahman, I am Shiva and all. So that's changed the question a little bit. Am I aware?
I make Brahman also into an object.
But am I aware you can't make into object? Are you clear? ಬ್ಲಾಂಕ್ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಯಾರಿಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾ ಅದೇ ಅವೇರ್ನೆಸ್ ಬ್ಲಾಂಕ್ ಅದು ಮೈಂಡ್ ರಮಣ ಮಹರ್ಷಿಗಳು ಇಷ್ಟು ಎಷ್ಟೇ ಇಷ್ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಆತ್ಮ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಅವೇರ್ನೆಸ್ ಸೊ ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿ ಆಸ್ ದ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ಆಮ್ ಐ ಅವೇರ್ ಹಿ ಸೆಡ್ ಹೂ ಆಮ್ ಐ ಓಕೆ That who am I question, people are misusing it, or rather wrongly interpreting it, misleading it.
You get objectified answers.
You get a very good answer. I am Brahman, I am Shiva Swarupi, I am going to establish an Atma. You get all answers. So just ask the question, am I aware? Right? So this you have to do. I told you Nididhyasa, right? Nididhyasa is, stay in the I-amness. I-amness is called Chidabhasa. Chidabhasa, you stay. So then, any thought comes, am I aware? Like that you do. So then let's see what happens, right?